Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going to the surface of Mars, where the Perseverance rover has returned a photo of what appears to be, as you can see here at foxnews.com, a rainbow in the background. Of all the images that have been returned to Earth from all of the rovers, I think this is the first of its kind. I went to the rover website, and I'm going to show you guys what I discovered. I think you guys are going to find quite fascinating. I know I did. I've got an update on the erupting volcano in the southern Caribbean. We're also going to go over to the western Pacific and take a look at this massive typhoon. This thing has grown exponentially in less than 24 hours. It did rapidly intensify, and this thing could probably get even larger. Right now, it's nearly 1,000 miles wide. Simply unbelievable. Also in this video, I've got a brand new picture slideshow, new sky phenomena photos sent in from all around the world. But first, here at the website, checking out the Schumann resonance, and you can see there's been a little bit of activity in the Schumann, couple of spikes that did convey over to the planetary K index, where we've had a couple of minor geomagnetic storms in the last 24 hours. That's not necessarily associated with a high-speed stream of solar wind. More than likely, what this is from is a tilt in the interplanetary magnetic field. It more than likely tilted south for the better part of 3 to 6 hours, temporarily creating a geomagnetic storm. Hopping over to the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera, looking at the seismographs that monitor the mighty supervolcano, look pretty much like they did yesterday, with the exception of no earthquakes today. All in all, pretty quiet. Looking at the global scene, global active earthquakes, right now as I do this video, there are a total of 45 active volcanoes, and here's a map of the volcanoes, as you can see here at volcano.si.edu. So right now there are a total of 45 volcanoes erupting worldwide around planet Earth. I'm going to take you guys now over to the Western Pacific. We're here at windy.com, and you can see the incredible satellite presentation of this now major typhoon. This storm could easily go up to a Category 5, as it's expected to be a Category 4 for the next 2.5 days. There's an absence of wind shear right now in its location, so that makes the environment very favorable for the formation of typhoons and hurricanes, and even the strengthening. The intensity right now of this storm is around 950 millibars. That's very low, and it looks like it's going to go lower as it's starting to develop an eye wall. This thing is really starting to crank. They're already feeling the outer bands of this storm that, once again, you can see over here at windy.com. This thing is reaching far, and it's reaching wide, and the eye wall is starting to appear. But luckily, right now, the models are showing this thing just skimming the Philippines, but that is always subject to change. This thing has got a wide reach, so they're going to see a lot of rain, as this storm's going to be in the area for over 4 days, and those outer bands loaded with heavy rainfall will be affecting the Philippines for the next 72 to 96 hours. You can see the storm over here at the Himawari, and it totally sticks out just above the equator. Again, this thing is very early, really shouldn't even be there. Hurricanes and cyclones and typhoons, what these things really are, they are heat engines. They move heat away from the equator, north in the northern hemisphere, south in the southern hemisphere. That's why they're called cyclones, and then up here they're called typhoons and hurricanes. And when you see one this early, that tells you more than likely there's a lot of heat radiating around the equator of planet Earth when these things fire up early, like this one here. And it's not even hurricane season in the northern hemisphere. These things don't normally form right at the equator, as this one here, even though it's early, it was at the 8-degree north latitude. But what it's doing, it's moving heat away from the equator northward. And then when these things get in cool waters, they slow down. So it's just doing its job, and right now its job is moving heat. I want to go back to this photo that was on foxnews.com showing the NASA Perseverance rover, and you can see what looks like a rainbow in the atmosphere of planet Mars. So what I did, I went and found the photo over at the Perseverance website, and you can find this link down below in the description box for the Mars Perseverance. Also, I did a video a few days ago pertaining to this image that was shared with me by three different people. And off to the right of this image, the far right, you can see what looks like a skeleton laying over there. That's just what it looks like. I'll leave it up to you guys to decide whatever you think it may or may not be. But I thought this was from the Perseverance, and it is not from the Perseverance. This one is from the Curiosity rover. So I've also put that link down below in the description box. That one was from the Curiosity. The one we're getting ready to look at is from Perseverance. And what I did was I found the image that contains not only one rainbow, but multiple rainbows. You're looking at Mars as Perseverance was making its close approach, getting ready to land. I found a few photos. These are from April. Right there's one that looks like some sort of a rainbow on both sides of this panoramic view, one over here and one over here. And what I did was I found some color in this rainbow shaft here, at least that's what it looks like. And of all the thousands of images that have been returned to Earth, very few have ever had what looks like a rainbow in them. So what that tells us is there could be some sort of moisture maybe in the atmosphere, or a increase of moisture over the years, since this seems to be something kind of new and there's color in there. And rainbows are formed as a form of light refraction. Light bends through particles and usually water molecules in the atmosphere. And what this looks like is water molecules are present in the atmosphere of Mars. That clearly looks like a rainbow to me. This is a different image, and I zoomed in on it as tight as I could without, you know, losing the clarity. This is the atmosphere of Mars taken by the Curiosity rover, and these are clouds. This is a black and white photo. I couldn't do anything with it. That's exactly how it was on the Curiosity website, and you can find that link below in the description box. This is a fairly new photo, and you can clearly see clouds present in the daytime sky of Mars. This thing here is kind of mysterious too. I found this just looking around. These images are quite interesting. It's not every day that we've been able to just sit down and go to another planet and look around on the surface. So every once in a while, I do go up and check out the photos from Curiosity and Perseverance and the other rovers that we've had over the years. And this is a statue from the Perseverance. Yeah, the Perseverance just sent this one back just within the past few weeks. And there's something sitting off in the distance here that doesn't necessarily look like an ordinary rock. It's got some sort of lines going around the top of it. There and there, they look to be very equal, like they were put there purposely. The top almost looks like a dome. This looks long and linear, like maybe 6, 8, maybe 10 feet long. And you can see it broke in half. So at one time, it was part of something bigger. And you can tell this doesn't look like a random rugged rock like you see elsewhere. Everything else looks like it's pretty random. Maybe they were once part of something bigger too, but this one here really sticks out like it was part of something very big, like maybe on the front of a structure or something like that. I don't know. It looks like to me it's got a splash of intelligent design associated with it. I don't know. As always, I'll leave it up to you guys to decide, but to me, that one there looks very, very curious, to say the least. Quick update on the volcano on St. Vincent Island. We're over here at zoom.earth. These are the latest images from Zoom Earth, and you can see there's been an eruption once again today, April 16th. The prevailing winds are now moving to the west, so you can see the plume is moving now westward instead of eastward. This is yet another large eruption that occurred a few hours ago. I've also received some video footage once again from David, whose mom's sister is on the island. And you're going to see a close-up view of an eruption that occurred yesterday on the 15th. This volcano has been very active the last few days, and it's not showing any signs of letting up. This one's got a very unique big circular cloud sitting on top of it. Very photogenic plume of ash and smoke billowing high up into the sky, coming from the volcano there on the left. That would be on the north end of St. Vincent Island, the plume over there on the right, and you can see it here from space via zoom.earth. There's the volcano on the right. There's the large plume from the 16th. The one I just showed you earlier was from the 15th. We've got now 45 active volcanoes around planet Earth, that being one of the 45 active volcanoes. And we're already seeing signs of typhoons and hurricanes in the northern hemisphere, and it's the middle of April. Could be a long hurricane season in the northern hemisphere. It's already starting. That is a Category 4 major storm. Dave and Nina out of Sarasota, Florida. Big long shelf cloud. They stopped the car, got out to take a picture of this very photogenic cloud that was reaching down towards the ground and had multiple layers up above the roll cloud down below. Jeff out of North Carolina also saw a very ominous-looking storm cloud stretching way off into the distance. He also shared these photos of some big beams at sunrise spanning out over the horizon. These are called crepuscular rays. You don't see them very often, but when you do, they are hard to miss. Melinda family out of Montana, big jumbo halo in the proximity of the sun. Keith out of Naples, Florida, beautiful photograph of the sun just setting below the horizon. Karen out of Bolton, United Kingdom. Look at this here. It looks like some sort of a wedge in the sky. These clouds definitely don't look natural. Something looks off in here, and that's what compelled Karen to take the photo. Great job, guys. Keep the photos coming. If you have any photos you'd like to share, you can send those to reports at MrMBB333.com. All of the photos end up here at the Sky Phenomenon Photo Gallery at the website, and sometimes I'll use them in a video just like you saw right here. Thanks for watching. Have a super day and be safe out there.